Good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope all of you are fit and fine. In our previous class, we have discussed a very important figure of speech, and we have seen that figure of speech was very absurd and very contradictory. That figure of speech was very absurd. Tell me the name, because sometimes this type of words also come in the exam, and questions come from which figure of speech this line had been taken. Okay. Which figure of speech is used? A figure of speech which is absurd. Which is absurd and contradictory. Because each figure of speech have their own meaning, have their own different meaning. So you should be well versed, well acquainted about this thing, that there is a figure of speech which is absurd and contradictory. But it is well founded, and the answer is paradox. In our previous class, we have discussed this thing or not, that paradox is a statement which looks absurd, this was the word, absurd and contradictory. This statement is absurd and contradictory, but it is well founded, but it is well established, it is founded with truth. And we have to discuss few examples, because figure of speech can be well understood by you by the means of the example only. Examples gives you an idea that yes, this type of sentence is used in paradox figure of speech. Okay. First example of paradox is the well-known example. I hope that this example everyone knows. The child is the father of man. The child is the child is the father of man. The child is the father of man. And I know that this example you will not forget all your whole life, because this is a famous paradox, famous contradiction, it's a famous contradictory words. And what we have found it, that it is well known. Okay. The child is the father of man. Here what we are seeing? We are seeing the contradictory and absurd statement of God. A paradox is a statement, and this is also a statement. Okay. And what we are seeing? That this statement is looking like an absurd thing. Because always we have seen that from the father, child comes. First of all, on the earth, father comes, then after that, child comes. In the same way, it is said that that Mr. Ram is the child of Mr. Shyam, then it will be looking well sounded word that yes, his father name is this, and after the father, this child had came. But when we say child had came first and father had came at the last, then it is looking like a absurd thing. It is looking like a vulgar thing, or not? That how you can say all these things, that first of all child came and then father came. But what we are saying, that this statement, which is looking contradictory and absurd, but it is well founded, in the sense that the child, which has all type of creative ideas, innovative ideas, don't understand this sentence in a literal manner. Okay? Because if you will understand this sentence in the literal manner, then you cannot take out the real meaning of this sentence. Okay? Here in this sentence, this means that child who has more innovative idea, the child who had more devotional, more collaborative thoughts regarding a thing, regarding the performance of a thing. It is said that because of that, he can overcome the man. Means to say that in the form of innovative idea, in the form of innovation, in the form of new thing, child can be called as the father of man. Child can be called as the father of man. Means child can oversee, child can overpass, child can overcome the man also. Next example is, there is no one so poor as wealthy misers. Okay, let's give a speech. There is no one so poor. Next example. There is no one so poor as wealthy miser. Miser mean anyone? What miser mean? Means the person who have so much money. Or the person who spends so much money on another person. The person who always donates money, who always gives money on particular festival to the needy one, or who always donate the money in charity, that is known as the miser man or miser person. This is the meaning of the miser or not? Am I right or wrong? Miser means the person who always keeps their money with them, but they don't want to spend money. That is known as the miser. Means the person who have the money but don't want to spend money on others. That is known as miser. Means who always keep things with them but don't want to spend. Okay. There is no one so poor as wealthy miser. the sentence consists of good words, or after reading the sentence what you are getting, that this is a good sentence or there is no any contradiction. What we are saying? We are saying that that this sentence contains contradiction, that no one, that there is no one, that there is no one so poor. Whether what we are looking, absurd words, and by combining all this absurd and contradictory word, a full sentence is framed. A full contradictory statement was framed. There is no one so poor. There is no one so poor. So poor means the person who doesn't have any money to eat, to feed themselves, to wear good clothes. A very pathetic condition. There is no one so poor as wealthy man. And what does not wealthy mean? Wealthy means the person which has so much of property, so much of money with them, fully developed person who had all type of comfort with them, but that person is a miser. Means a wealthy person, a prosperous person, a rich person. A rich person is of what type? A rich person is of miser type. Is of miser type. Means he doesn't want to spend money. He had money with him. He had name, fame, and property, everything he had, but he doesn't want to spend money. Then what happened? That person is considered as so poor. That person is considered as so poor. Means so poor means poorest person, not poor, poorest person. Because God had given him the wealth and the property. In spite of that, that person is a miser. Means to say that the person who is sitting, the poor person who is sitting on the street, or the poor person who is sitting in the temple and begging for their food, or the poor person who is walking bare feet on the road, or who doesn't have their clothes to wear, they are shivering due to the cold, or sometimes we see that due to the bad weather, due to the cold, many people die also. Then what we see? We see that this is the poorest person who doesn't have any clothes, that's why that person had died. That person doesn't have any money, that's because of that he died, because of his food, because he doesn't got the food. Then we feel that yes, this is the poorest person. But what happened here? That there is no one so poor. Means you are the poorest person, in the sense that you are so poorest that you have got the money, you have got the property, everything. In spite of that, you are miser. Means to say that you are poorest person. And while reading all this statement, what we are analyzing? We are analyzing that this statement is a contradictory statement. This is looking absurd sentence. Here it is, we have used the word paradox statement. which looks absurd. Is absurd, is it? By hearing all this thing, it is looking good. It is providing some comfort to our ears that that person is an amazing person, but he or she, whoever the person is, that person is the poorest person. This is a contradiction, this is a satire, this is a comment on that person, that you have so much money, so much property, in spite of that you are the poorest person, because you are the miserable person who doesn't want to spend money. So it is said that this type of persons are known as the miser person, and by reading all these sentences we have got the knowledge that this is a contradictory statement. But this word is also there. But what? But is well founded. But it is well-founded means that this sentence consists of knowledge. This sentence want to give us some knowledge. This sentence is full of knowledgeable thoughts. This sentence consists of thought-provoking idea, thought-provoking intention, because it is said that there is no one so poor as wealthy miser. By reading sentence, we have got the knowledge that this is a contradictory statement. But what we have got the knowledge? We have got the knowledge that it is well founded, that it is well known, that it is seen by us that wealthy misers are the poorest persons. Means whole statement which is looking contradictory and absurd, but this sentence is giving us some knowledge, giving us some thoughts about the wealthy miser. That's why it is said that absurd sentence which gives you a knowledge, which gives a, it gives you a new thought, and it is well founded, well known. Okay. Note down this, otherwise I have to look at this. Note down or take the screenshot. Next figure of speech is repetition. Repetition. Okay. Repetition. What this word repetition mean? Repetition is a word in which a word is repeated many times for expressing intense feeling. Okay. In repetition, a word is repeated many times for expressing intense feeling. In repetition, in repetition, in repetition, a word is repeated many times. In repetition, a word is repeated many times. In repetition, a word is repeated many times for expressing intense feeling. For expressing intense feeling. For expressing intense feeling. In repetition, a word is repeated by the word only. Repetition, you have got the knowledge. Repeat. You say that, na? Repeat means the thing which we do again and again. Repeat. In the same way, in the sentence, when a word is repeated many times, there is a word which is repeated. There is a word which is repeated many times. There is a word which is repeated many times for expressing intense feeling. Means in a sentence when a word is repeated many times. And I hope that this would be the most easiest figure of speech, that in this there is a repetition of words. A repetition of word in the sentence in the sense that it wants to create an intense feeling. Okay, intense feeling is the most important feeling, the most desirous feeling, that is known as the intense feeling. Okay, like one example is there, a little grave
Dark the darkest night. Same word is repeated.